Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Commodity TV here from the Precious Metal Show, the Edelmetallmesse in Munich. And with me here is for the first time Firesteel Resources, Michael Hepworth, the president and CEO of the company. And he wants to give us an insight into his terrific company. Welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for taking the time. What is Firesteel Resources about? And I saw already on your card the Laiva gold mine. You have a joint venture in Finland. What's going on there?
That's right. Well, we've been very lucky. We have acquired 60% of the Nordic Mines operation of Laiva gold mine for $20 million. Now, it's a fully permitted, past producing gold mine. It's the mill is completely built, so there's no capital costs or anything like that that are needed. It's a restart. It's 600,000 ounces in the ground, and we should be in production probably by May next year if the money comes in as planned on the 15th of November.
Okay, so you have to pay the 20 million, that's like in stage payments. How do you do that?
The 20 million will come in. There are two options right now on the table. One is that the 20 million will come in one tranche and we will get 60%.
That's like equity then, or
yes,
what is it?
Okay. It's an earn-in. Okay. So it's coming in as equity. The second option, which is a possibility, but it's not as high a probability as the 20 million coming in, would be 17 million in the first tranche, and then another 3 million in a second tranche at a later stage. But there's no real sense in doing that. And then we would offer the Nordic Mines shareholders Firesteel shares for the balance of the operation.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. So when you say you can go like May into production, let's assume it will be like by summer, because mining is adventure, we know that all. Always something happens, yeah? What would be the annual production? Would it be only gold or also some byproducts?
Well, there is some silver in there as well, but it's mostly gold. I'm really not at liberty to tell you how much production will be because we don't have a pre-feasibility study. We have done about 6 months' work with consultants. We've had two lots of consultants looking at it. They all agree on the numbers, and it's very interesting. We've got about a six-year mine life without any exploration upside, which there are three properties to look at. So we think there's considerable exploration upside as well.
When you say three properties to look at, you have to still buy them or they belong already?
They already belong. And two of them have very good gold showings and some drill results. Very similar results to the two areas where we've got the two pits. And there's another one to the northwest of the mine, probably also about 2 kilometers away, where we've had as good grade as 44 grams over a small interval. So, you know, there's some good gold results, but the whole property has gold grades of about 1.6, 1.8. That seems to be fairly typical.
Okay, super. But it's an underground mine, is that correct? It's an underground mine?
No, it's an open pit. We have two open pits.
Yeah.
The one is the north pit, which is open at depth and open to the east. And then there's the south pit, which has really not actually even been worked. They've really taken off the till and exposed the ore, but that's about all they've done. They've done very little work in there, but that's also open at depth. And the holes have all been relatively shallow. We have very few holes over 250 meters.
That's okay. And they ended in mineralization. Well, that's always nice to have.
And there is some evidence that the mineralization improves at depth. There's not a lot, but because we don't have much depth. But
super. Can you comment maybe a little bit, let's say, on the metallurgy from the past? Maybe you have done already some tests, because I think this is something which is for the economics for the mine later on very important.
Well, the recoveries were not good in the past. Yeah. Our metallurgist is working actually on the recoveries at the moment, and they've, again, this is not a number that I can actually release because it's not at 43101 standard, but we believe that we can significantly improve the recoveries. The major problem with this mine was the dilution. What happened was they were doing bulk mining essentially, and it needs to be much more selective. So they were mining, doing blasts of 60,000 tons at a time and mixing ore and waste, and they were getting dilution of about 50%. So this was a problem. And then every step of the process along the way, so for example, not only was there a dilution problem, then when it went to crushing, a lot of oversized material was going through the crusher and into the mill. And of course, the gold is in the smaller sizes, so that was a problem. So at each step of the process, we've identified areas where we can improve the success and actually increase the recoveries and make it a more profitable operation.
Okay, fantastic. Wow, great. So can you elaborate a little bit more, let's say, on the game plan for 2018? For sure you want to restart, yeah? Let's assume you have the money in. So let's assume May, June you can start. What else do you have to do before you can restart? Talking about, let's say, infrastructure, power, water, I assume everything is in place, but do you have to buy, let's say, big caterpillars? Do you need to buy conveyor belts or just that we get an idea about, please.
Let me give you an idea of what we're doing. So that we expect the money to come in November the 15th of this year. So we should have the money within about 2 weeks. What will happen then is we've got two or three things that we've got to do. Obviously, there's some mine planning that's got to be done. We've got some metallurgy that's got to be done. But and of course, recruitment is a big issue. And we'll be looking for about 120 people. So we're very keen on looking for a good process engineer, a good drill and blast engineer. Yeah. We've identified some people, but we haven't got all of the people that we need. We have already appointed a general manager, and he will be starting as soon as the money comes in. What we do not need any infrastructure. There's all weather roads, there's power, there's everything that we need. I mean, it was a past producing mine, there's no problem with that. We will need to buy some pumps. We will need to fix the conveyor system. That's not working. We will need to reline the pipe to the tailings because it's a steel pipe and there's no liner. So we want to put an HDPE liner in, that kind of thing. So there's about 6 months work, but there's nothing major. Now, we are not really going to be buying equipment because we're going to use a contract miner. We will load the ore, but the contract miner will move the waste, and we will control the blasting. In fact, we will do the blasting ourselves.
So that makes all very good, scalable, and for the calculation, it's much better, right? Okay, super. Is this all in the 20 million then in, or do you have to raise additional money for that work?
We will probably have to raise a few million a little later on because this money will take us to production, but it's all going into the production. It's not going, so Firesteel itself will need some money for marketing, G&A, all the things that it
like hard dollars.
Yeah. So that will have to be raised probably within the next 6 months.
Okay. Super. Well, thank you very much. It was a good insight, I would say. Keep fingers crossed, and please do it because we need much more gold in this world.
Well, absolutely, and hopefully you'll have me back sometime, and I can give you an update when we're producing.
Definitely, we do that. Thank you much, Michael. Thank you. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Michael Hepworth, the president and CEO of Firesteel Resources, and you heard it. They want to, not only turn around, they want to bring again in production the Laiva gold mines, and in Finland. And I think you're on a good path on that, and we will keep you posted definitely for this. 600,000 ounces are already indicated and inferred in the ground. Of course, they have to prove some more, but all is quite shallow. It's all open pit. And also what is interesting, all the drill holes ended in the mineralization, so there's much more room. They have three more properties to go for. Let's check it out. Thanks for watching us. Bye-bye from Munich.